Welcome to Mr. Math Academy. Grow your math brain.
Hello friends, welcome back to Mr. Math Academy. So today in this video we'll discuss about the topic matrices here. Actually it's a plural of matrix here. So before going to the introduction part, we'll just go over. Okay, I'll just take the numbers here, some few numbers. Let us consider 1, 3, minus 5 and 6. Okay, these are some four numbers what I have taken here. So for these numbers, how I can arrange, okay, how I can arrange in the form of a matrix, that's important here. So this number can be arranged in this format, 1, 3, minus 5, 6, okay. This is the one method how I can represent this matrix here, okay. So again, these four numbers I can represent in the vertical direction also. So I can represent this as 1, 3, minus 5 and 6. Okay, now this is a one more type of the matrix how I can represent the given numbers here. Okay, now after that there is a one more method how I can represent these four numbers, because if I take this first two numbers 1 and 3, if I take like this, so this is 1 3, like first row, that is a horizontal place, horizontal position, and second two number, that is minus 5 and 6, as well I can take this will also be in this format. So means what? So whatever the given, that is the numbers or any characters or any alphabets, I can represent in this format here, that is in a horizontal position or vertical position or in both the cases. Okay, now these are nothing but the matrix here. Now what is the use of the matrix in general? So actually, if suppose this is a basically, if you go for the some linear equations in a simple mathematical linear equations, to solve such kind of equations, so this matrix will helps us. Okay, so that is the basic how we are going to use the matrix. Now you just see here, this is a, if suppose, so this is actually I can represent these numbers in this horizontal format, the entire thing, as well as the vertical one. Now here it's something like, you can just see here, I can represent here, so this will be the rows here. So this is a row, only single row is there, that is a horizontal single row. Now when you just see from that this one, so this is one column, 2 3 4. Now there are four columns and one row is there, so that is the one type of the arrangement. Now for the same number, if you just go here, so this is the first row, second row, third and fourth, means there are four number of rows are there. But what about the columns? So the column, only thing is, it's only a single column. Okay, now if you go for the third case, that is the third part, so we'll be having a two rows, that is a one, two rows. So this is a column 1, column 2, right? Now these are the rows and the columns. Now what I mean to say is, so actually what is a matrix here? So matrix means it's a rectangular arrangement of, it's a rectangular arrangement of rows and the columns. I'll go here. So matrix is a rectangular arrangement of, I'll take here, matrix is a rectangular arrangement of rows and columns. Okay, actually the matrix is a rectangular arrangement of rows and columns, in which the main condition is this one, in which each row should have the equal number of elements. So this is a basic condition, in which each row should have equal number of elements. Okay, this is the first condition. Okay, and each column will also be have the same number of elements, and each column should have same number of elements. Okay, this is the main definition of a matrix here. So I repeat here, so matrix is a rectangular arrangement of rows and the columns, so in which each row will have the same number of elements and each column will also have a same number of elements. That is the two condition that gives the matrix here. Now we just go for this same example here, how the rows and columns will be having the same number of elements. If suppose I am having a row here, this is only one row is there. Now how many rows? It's only one row. What about the columns here? We just see here, this is a column 1. I'll just represent here. So this is, I can take it as a C1, C2, C3 and C4. So this is a one R1 I'll take. Now in this example, there is only one row. Okay. Now what about the columns here? The column 1 will also have the one element. Column 2 also have the one element. Column 3 is also have the one element. Column 4 also have the only one element. Means each column here, each column will have the same number of elements. That is only one here. Now for this example, so there are four rows, 1, 2, 3, 4. What about the column? The column is only one. Now you just go for the rows here. The row 1 will have only one number, that is one element. The row 2 is also have the only one element. The row 3 is also have the only one element. The row 5 will also have the only one element. So element means that is actual the position of that particular number or character or any alphabet. Okay, that is the actual position here. So this minus 5 indicates it's something like value or character or anything. Okay, but this position is nothing but here, it is a position of the element here. Okay, now these are the elements here. Now if you go for the third part here, that is the third example, we'll come to know what will be the exactly the matrix here. Now you just see here, so this is the R1, so this is the R2, C1, C2, that is the column 1, column 2. Now you just see here, so in the column 1, sorry, in the row 1, how many elements will be having? We are having a one element is there, we are having a two element is there. So means what? The row 1 will have a two elements. Again row 2, the row 2 will also have the same number of elements. Okay, if suppose I am having a one more row, that is a row 3 if I am having here, so that will also have the same number of elements. Means only two elements should be there. Like this, I can have one more element. It may be a 5, it may be a 6, it may be a 7 or 8. Means what? If I am taking the row 3, it should also have the same number of elements. Means again, it should be having only the two elements. If it is three element, means it's not a matrix here. Okay. Now this is the first condition, that is each row should have an equal number of elements. Now each column should have the same number of elements. Again, we have to go for the column also. Okay, now these are the columns here. Now if I just go for the column here, so this is a column 1. So again we'll be having element 1 and element 2. So means what? We'll be having a two elements here. Now go for the second column. Again here also 1 is there, 2 is there. Means what? There are two elements are there. So like that, so if a matrix is nothing but it should be a rectangular element of the rows and columns in which each row should have the equal number of elements like this. Okay, and again in the each column we should have a equal number of elements. If I take the one more example, if suppose I'm having a number 1, 2, 3, 4 and somewhere here 6. Now we just go for this one example, whether it is a matrix or not. Okay, so here just see, so how many elements are there here? For if this is a row 1, so this is a row 1, this is a row 2. Okay, in row 1 we'll be having a three elements. So three element is this one. Okay, that is 1, 2, 3. So this is these are the three elements in the row 1. Again, what about the row 2? So only 4 is there and 6 is there. Means only two elements are there here. The row 2 will be having only two elements. Means it is not a matrix here, because each rows will have the same number of elements. If this is a three elements are there, means the row 2 will also be have the three elements should be there. Okay, now again we'll go for the column also, whether it is satisfied or not. Now there are column 1 is there, column 2, column 3. Again you just see here, column 1 will have the two elements, that is 1 and 4. Column 3 is also having the two elements, that is 3 and 6. What about the column 2? It is having only one element, that is the 2. So here we don't have an element here. Means this will not satisfy the given condition here. So this is not a matrix at all. Okay, I hope so. This is basically okay. I'll give one more example here in the form of alphabets. Suppose A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay, is this is a matrix? Okay, obviously, because this is a matrix here. Because so this is a row one. So this is a row one. This is a row two. So the row one will have the three elements here. So there are three elements here, and again the row two will also be having the three elements here. Now what about the columns? First case is over. That is the first condition. It's satisfied. What about the columns here? Again the columns also we have to verify. So these are the columns here. That is a C1, C2, and C3. So the column one will are having a two element. That is A and B. So this is the first one. Second, the column two, again it is also having the same number of element. That is the two elements. Column C3 will also be having the same number of elements. So means what? This is a given condition, satisfied the given condition. So means what? So the first one is also having a matrix. So this is also a matrix. Okay, this one will solve it. This one will also be having a matrix here. That is a representation of the matrix here. Now this is not at all a matrix here. Okay, I hope you have got some basic idea about what is a matrix here. Okay, now we'll go for what are the basic things we have to remember when you are writing the matrix here. Okay, so basically we have to remember that three important parameters, like three important basic concepts we have to remember when you are writing some matrix here. That is for the representation of the matrix. So we have to remember three things. So while while writing the matrix, that is for the identification of the matrix. So when you are writing any matrix here, we have to concentrate on basic three things. So in that case, the very first one is, so we have to remember that what is the order of the matrix. So you can take order of the matrix first. Second, go for the elements. That is the number of elements, how many elements are there, okay, in that particular matrix. Now third one, we'll go for the position of the matrix. Position of matrix. So these three things we have to remember, okay, whenever we are writing the matrix here. So these are the three basic concepts we have to be remember. Okay, now we'll go for one by one here. What is an order? So what are the elements? How many elements the matrix should have? Okay, now what about the position of the matrix? Now generally I'll take an example of any two matrix, and that is a matrix here. That is, if I take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, minus 6, any 9. Okay. So this matrix can be represented by like a square matrix. Okay. Basically, in general, we are using for the representation of the matrix by using the square bracket here. Okay. Now I can represent this matrix. Always we have to represent, we are representing in the form of a capital letter. Like you can take A, B, C, whatever it is. I'll take capital A is equal to, means the matrix A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, minus 6 and 9. Okay. Now this is actually the matrix. First we'll verify whether it is a matrix or not. You just see here, this is a row 1, this is a row 2, this is a row 3. I'll take here. So this is a row 1, row 2, row 3. So 1, column 1, column 2, column 3. The row 1 will have a 3 number of elements. Again, the row 2 will also have the 3 number of elements. Row 3 will also be having the 3 elements. Okay, means what? It satisfies the first condition. Now we'll go for the column 1. Again, the column 1 will have the 3 elements. Column 2 is also having the 3 elements. Column 2 and 3, both are having the 3 elements. Means what? This satisfied the given conditions. Now this is basically a first thing, is it's a matrix. Okay, now we'll go for the what is an order of the matrix here. Now order of the matrix means, okay, I have to represent this matrix in the form of a rows and column. Means how many rows are there and how many columns are there. So how many rows are there here? So one row, you can just see here, this is a row 1, row 2, this is a row 3. Means three rows are there. I'll take here, these are the rows. So these are the columns here. So there are three rows. What about the columns? Three columns are there here. Okay. Now these rows and columns I can take in the form of a 3 cross 3 matrix, or you can take 3 by 3 matrix. So generally, so this matrix we can write somewhere here. That is the order of the matrix is 3 cross 3, which means so the first indicate, the first number always indicates it's a number of rows. That is 1, 2, 3. 3 rows are there. Okay, the second most number indicates always it's the number of the columns. Okay, if suppose instead of that, if suppose here there is no change. If I take some 2 cross 3 matrix, if the matrix is 2 cross 3 matrix, instead of that, if I write 3 cross 2 matrix, it's become a row. For example, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now this is one example I'll take here. So here there are two rows. So this is the row 1, the row 2. Okay, two rows are there. So there are three columns here. 1, 2, 3. Now it becomes two rows, three columns. Always, whenever we are representing the order, it becomes a 2 cross 3. Means what? The first number indicates always the number of rows. That is only one, two rows are there. The second number indicates it is always the columns. That is the number of columns here. 1, 2, 3. Okay. This is the order of the matrix here. If suppose, if I take in the reverse order, that is, if I write this one, like 3 cross 2. Okay. If I write 3 cross 2. So first layer, first one, that is the number indicates it's a number of rows. Here we don't have a 3 rows here, only 2 rows. So this indicates the columns. Here we will be having a 3 columns. So means what? This will not be, this is not a correct order of the matrix here. Always whenever we are representing the matrix, we have to write the first number as a rows, the second number as a column here. That's the number of columns. Now this is basically the order of the matrix. Okay. Now we'll go for the elements. Actually this element means, so number of elements. It's a number of elements. Now we just consider how many elements are there. There are 1, 2, 3, 4. Means total 9 elements are there. So 9 elements are there. So here 6 elements are there. Like that I can take any example. Okay. You just count here how many elements are there. We can just directly count and we can write. If suppose some 1000 numbers are there, okay, some 500 into 500 cross matrix or something, means higher number should be there. It may be some 40 into 40 matrix is there. Okay, in that case we have to find out how many elements are there in that matrix. Okay, in that case what we have to do here, okay, only thing is you just multiply the rows into columns. So here there are 9. So here it is what this indicates, it's an order. Okay, if we just multiply rows into columns, so that is 3 into 3, which gives 9. So this 9 indicates it's a number of elements in the matrix, in the given matrix. Okay, so similarly here 2 cross 3 matrix means you just take 2 into 3, there will be a 6 elements. Okay, similarly thing is total number of elements in the matrix will be given by the multiplication of the rows into columns. That is the simple thing. Okay, now what about the position of the matrix? So the position of the matrix means, so the which element is located, which the, what is the position of the particular element we have to represent here. Okay, how to represent the position of the matrix means, in general case, so this is a 3 cross 3 matrix here. I'll go for the general condition here. So what is the position of the matrix? So position of the matrix means, so the same thing I can write in the general form. If I take like A 1 1, that is always, you just remember, always the first number indicates it's a rows. The second number indicates it's a column here. That is A 1 1, A 1 2, A 1 3. Okay, which means this is the first row entire thing. This one indicates, that is two numbers you can see here. This is A 1 1. So this first number always indicates it's a number of row. The second number indicates it's a number of column. Okay. Now here first row, first column. this is the first row, first column, sorry, second column, first row, third column. Okay, means what? This is always the first row elements. Again, if I take this is what? So this is the entire thing, it's a second row. So A2 I can take. Okay, now this is the second element here. This is the second element of the first row. I can take here like this, A21, which indicates what? It's a A21 is indicates it's a second row, first column element. This one, this part. Again, this is A22 means it's a second row, second column element. This representation give the position of the elements here. Actually, this is not a position of the matrix here. So this is a position of elements here. Okay, sorry, position of the elements. First thing is order, second one is a number of elements, and third one is a position of elements, which is the position of the element here. Okay, this is A23, like that. Okay, here again I go for the A31, that is a third row, first column element. Again A32, A33. Now for the above example, so for this example, okay, that is a given matrix element, I can go with the I can represent with the what is the position of the element here. Okay, similarly this is a given matrix here. This is actually the general format here. Now what about the matrix means order of this matrix? I mean, that is a general thing here. How many rows? 1 2 3 we have to represent with the first thing is first number is with respect to row, second number is 1 2 3, this is 3 × 3 matrix. Okay, this indicates it's an order of the matrix here. So this is a 3 × 3 matrix, indicates this is a row. Actually the first number indicates it's a row, so this is a columns. Okay, so you have to represent like this. If you just interchange, first thing is first number is a column, second number is a row, means it will not become the valid one. Okay, now this is the row into column, this is the order of the matrix here. So this is a element, these are all the elements here. So each and everything, it's a element here. Now what number of element means? So you just see here 3 6, total 9 elements are there. Okay, if suppose easily you can count here, okay, only few numbers are there. If suppose some 100 × 100 matrix is there, in that case difficult for me to calculate entire thing. So in that case what we have to do here, the general thing is to calculate the number of elements, only thing is you just multiply rows into columns. So that is the whatever the order is there, you just multiply the order, that is 3 × 3 means 3 × 3, which gives 9. So this indicates the total number of elements in the given matrix. It may be 100 times or 100 × 100 × whatever it is the matrix. Okay, you can calculate, you just multiply this order of the matrix, you will get the number of elements. Now position of the element means whichever the element we required, we can represent with the general way. Okay, whether it is a A32 or A33, like that, means second row, third column, or whatever it is, so we can represent with the position where it is exactly located. That is the position of the matrix. Okay, now this is the general format for the previous example. Now I'll represent that is a general format or general representation of the matrix. What is the general representation of the matrix? I'll go here. So general representation of a matrix. So general representation of the matrix means, if suppose if I take the matrix A, okay, so the in this way, if I take this is the small a 1 1, so which indicates it's a first row, first column element. Now first row, second column element, so always this indicates it's a first row. I'll take like this a1 a1, like that up to a1, means entire thing the first number indicates it's a row. Now this is the first column element, second column element, now this is the third, now this is the fourth, etc. Up to how many elements? I can have a n number of elements. Okay, up to n number of elements. Now similarly I can go for the second row. So this is the second row, A2 A2 A2, up to I can have a A2, means entire thing this is a second row, entire thing it's a second row indicates. Now this is the first element, that is the first column. Second row, first column element. Second row, second column. This one is second row, third column element. Second row, fourth column. Again, this is the second row, nth column element. Okay, again I'll write one more row here. A3, this is the third row, first column element. Third row, second column element. Third row, third column element. Third row, fourth column element, etc. up to third row, nth column element. Okay, means what? The first thing is entire thing, it's a row up to n number of element, a first row, second row, third row, etc. What about the columns? 1, 2, 3, 4, up to n number of columns. Okay. Similarly, I can write in the vertical also. So, up to here, if I just go on like that, if you're writing, so what will be the last number? Okay. So, this is the A. So, you just see the first number 1, 2, 3. Means what it indicates? It's a rows. Okay. This is the first row, second row, third row, 4, 5, 6, 7, etc. up to n number of rows, means already n you have taken, I'll take m number of rows. So now again here, again this is the same thing, m number of rows. So this is a m number of rows, entire thing it's a m number of rows. What about the elements, column elements? So it is a 1 1 1. This is the first element, m rowth, first column, m rowth, second column element. So this is a m row and third column element. This is the m, 1 2 3 4 up to m. So 4 4 4 4 is there, you can just write the 4 here. Similarly, so am is there, that is a m row, and n is there, you just write n here. Okay, this is a general representation of the matrix here. Now what about the order of the matrix? Order of the matrix, how many rows are there, how many columns are there? So what will be the last row? So m is the last row. Okay, first I'll represent with the m. What about the column? The last column up to nth column. So this is the order of the matrix, that is m cross n matrix. So this is the m cross n matrix is the general representation of the matrix here. Okay, I hope you are getting this one. So in between this, if any row and any column, if I want to find out, means easily I can find out. Okay, that is by giving some any examples we can find out here. So which element I need to find out in this matrix, like that. Okay, I hope you are getting this basic introduction about the matrix here. So I'll just repeat what we have done till now. So one thing is basic definition of the matrix. Okay, the second thing is how we are going to represent the matrix here, whether the column matrix or row matrix. Okay, and how the matrix can be identified, whether it's a matrix or not, because actually the matrix is nothing but it's a rectangular arrangement of the rows and columns in which each row will have the equal number of or same number of elements, and each column will have the same number of elements. Okay, this is a basic condition for a matrix here. Okay, second thing is, so we have to study what is the basic terms when you are writing the matrix here. There are basically three things we have to remember. That is, the first one is the order of the element, order of the matrix. Second thing is what are the number of, how many number of elements are there, that is the number of elements in the matrix. The third one, it's a what is the position of that particular element in that particular matrix here. Okay, so these three things we have to remember that. So now we'll go in the next video, we'll go for the what are the types of the matrices here. So that will also be there. Next video we'll go for the what are the types of the matrix here. Okay, if you like this video, share with your friend. Okay, share, comment, okay, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.